spare fan belt.
Yeah, fan belt.
Okay. Anything else apart from stockings you could use?
Well, there is a temporary fan belt on the market we can purchase.
No, I meant a pair of socks or your trousers.
Haven't found them successful.
No, you haven't tried. You haven't found them successful. Okay, don't use your trousers. Okay. Are we there?
Not nearly.
Oh, he's nearly there with the stocking. Believe me, you can't see it, but he is doing it. Oh, there we are. We're going to have a fan belt, and Elizabeth will be able to drive off in about 1 minute's time, but I think it's high time you went back inside for the crunch with Zig and Zag. Oh, there we are. Done it.
He's on form, it's all right.
He is, yeah.
I think it's important.
He gets carried away sometimes, Christopher, when he drinks fizzy pop.
Does he? Mm-hmm. Have you had some fizzy pop this morning?
Yes, I have!
What kind of fizzy pop?
Cola!
Have you burped yet?
No.
Okay. Now, who's coming on the show later?
That would have been a scandal. The papers would have got hold of that. They would have been burping Zig.
They would have turned it round, wouldn't
they? Yeah, twisted the whole thing upside down.
Well, it's got to be worse.
There'd be seven women
involved.
Other
end. Yeah. And then I've got a safer spread.
Zig. Okay.
Yeah. We've got Brookie Stars coming in.
Who's coming in?
Brookie in the bathroom.
We've got
Teddy's coming in.
Coming in.
Yeah.
And we've also got Anna.
Anna the nanny.
Scarlet woman.
She's a scarlet escort woman.
She is. That's scandal. I'm not even going to talk about it because that's just scandal.
Okay, then.
Not even sure what it means, but it definitely is scandal.
Okay, we got some mad mail. Great mad mail. Thanks for sending it.
We're
going to read it out now. Here we go.
Most sincerely, we've been
this was from Mark M. Callier, and he said that he sent me in an Isle of Man 50p, but haha, you can't spend it because it's not legal tender. But the funny thing is, Mark, it's not a 50p note at all, it's a 50 quid note. Thanks very much. You made a mistake.
That's what Ziggy bought.
Okay, what's this then, Mark?
Have a look at that.
What is this?
That is from Jane and Melissa in Plymouth.
It's not a celebrity burnt toast section, is it?
It certainly is. Cause
wow!
Look there, Cindy Crawford's toast, which actually was from a breakfast I had with her in Hollywood.
Zag brought me that one. In fact, Zag got me all of these celebrity pieces of toast that he's been on lunch or breakfast with people.
Isn't this sent in by a viewer?
Yeah, well, pretend.
That's a little.
And here's one from the Queen when I had a little brunch with her, talking about my OBE.
When did you meet the Queen?
The other day. And there's one of Zig's, which I put in myself, and Melissa, and lots more other ones there.
Thank you very much indeed.
Finally, Jane and Melissa, thanks.
So, yeah, this is a picture of you in your car. I did it on my school computer and with the help of my friend Patrick Chambers from Freddie Kenny.
What a clever
car. He's 8 3/4 and it's cool.
That is very excellent.
Well, brilliant.
Isn't it amazing what you can do on a computer?
Have you played the funny face game behind a piece of paper?
No.
Okay, so you look miserable like this. Ready? Like that?
Yeah, the minute.
I've got a funny feeling it's not really going to work, is it?
No, you got to change your face. One more go. Ready?
You see, Chris. What makes it change?
Oh,
no, like Chris, can I have a quick word, Chris?
What?
See, he thinks that it'll actually make it change. He doesn't have to do anything.
Okay, you show him. You show him.
Okay, me. Batteries of God!
Anyway, look, here's the restoration on my mail tip.
Mad mail, please, a big mail for two legs. I'll do it for much money.
Okay, and we got the Brookie Stars coming, so don't miss that. But
indeed, the Brookie. Hey, the Christmas Clippy. Does the goat get a lift and a member team phone? It's just fun.
It's a long way, but what's going to happen if Mrs. Metcalf doesn't get her milk? The kids don't get their cornflakes. Dad doesn't get his porridge. And Mum doesn't get her cup of tea. So come on, lads. Look lively.
Wouldn't breakfast be a disaster if you didn't have fresh milk delivered every morning?
Well, I don't know what you're laughing at. Auntie Ethel's coming to tea. They want two extra.
Muller Light from Muller. Less than 100 calories, made to more than a thousand. When you need some extra milk, just leave a note out.
48 extra silver cups?
Are you kidding?
No, are you kidding?
I suggest you take one person at a time and start with me. Not an ordinary girl.
It's Tuesday! Oh, hello, come over here. It's 7:28, big breakfast here. And the question about that clip was, did the goats get a lift? And the answer is yes, and that's from Lloyd Carr's brand new video, which is called Say You Want to Save the World, from his new single, of course, which is the same name. And it's all about Sting, apparently. Today's question of the day is, do you or somebody you know share a name with a famous person? And if so, how does it affect your being? Although I share a name with a top DJ, being just 12 years old, I've got a long way to go before I share his girth. And that's from Simon Bates in Eastleigh.
Hey!
Hey! Peter Smith from Hastings has called in. I'm sure I could get the weather right more often than Peter, I think, says that Peter Smith. And Lucy Holt from Oxford has called in saying, my aunt's called Julie Andrews, but she's never sang a rainbow. Anyway, there you are. The phone number, if you want to call, isn't on the back of these cards, which is a little unfortunate. But anyway, the number's 0819851111 or fax it on 0819852222. Famous namesakes, please, or infamous namesakes. Now, Sonic Bikes, this is what we're giving away all week on the Washing Line game. Just rolled off the production line, exclusive to the Big B. Once again, I've got to tell you, they're not that small. Val is, in fact, 10 feet tall himself. They're huge, beautiful things. Who's online wanting to play the game? Hello?
Hello, it's Norman.
How are you, Norman?
I'm fine, thank you, Chris.
And where are you from, Norm?
I'm from Nuneaton.
It's Stormy Norman from Nuneaton.
Hey!
Now, Norman, we were going to have Vic Reeves on the Washing Line today because his new show starts, Reeves and Mortimer, the smell of Reeves and Mortimer, on BBC Two tonight. But we've come up with a more topical one. Are you ready for this?
Just about.
But it's very, very easy. It's so easy, in fact, that as the first clue, you've got the red herring, which is the first time this ever happened. So who do you think it is? Think about a topicality. Who could it be today? You don't even get a clue because it's that easy. Topicality. Who could it be?
Topicality. Who could it be?
Come on. We've talked about it already today. Come on. Who could it be?
Nigel Mansell.
Oh, no. Oh, goodbye. Really? And now to our Nigel Mansell lookalike of the week here. Dad, Gary, and he's got clue number two. But first of all, we need caller number two. Hello?
Hello?
Who are you?
Sandra from Barnsley, Chris.
Okay, lovely to talk to you. Here's clue number two from Gary, which is an umbrella, which of course you put up when it's raining. So think about the rain, umbrella, and topicality. And the answer is?
No idea.
Okay, well, very easy, I can tell you that much. Hello, who's on line three?
Hello, it's David from Norwich.
Okay, how old are you?
30.
You sure?
Yeah, right, okay, 31.
Well, you might get this then, because this person is about your age. You're 2-3 years older, I think. Jenny, what have you got? A blonde wig. And the answer is?
Robbie Coltrane?
It's really easy. Hello. Who's on line four?
Hello, it's Angela from Swindon.
What's the answer? You don't even need clue number four. Come on.
And you're not going to show me the four?
I'll show you in a minute, but just have a guess anyway.
Madonna.
Madonna, yes, you see. Louise, you had a copy of Vogue, and John had a Madonna kind of cone thing here. Do you want to try that, John? No, don't. You're on your own. Okay, you've won. Well done.
Right.
Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Thanks for playing. Still to come on the show, we'll be unveiling the gadget that takes the spade work out of gardening. In fact, here it is. but now I've got to go upstairs to meet A, Teh, and Anna from Brookie.
Hello.
They're from Brookie. It's Kasia.
Brookie in the bathroom.
Kasia.
My
Kasia. You play.
You two are on TV, you are.
Oh, yeah.
You're on telly. You
are. I thought you were.
Well, I am, but only in the morning.
But you're on telly more than we are.
Yeah.
Are we?
Yeah.
And you're better looking, aren't you?
No, I'm not.
Yes, you
no,
are.
No, I'm not.
And I haven't had my beers.
Are you doing all right?
No, I'm doing
all right.
Yes,
no, I'm kidding.
I'm European. We can talk.
Oh, the two conversations of you don't know what's going on. It's like a game of tennis. We watch this doubles pair or this doubles pair. What were you talking about?
You two.
He was asking how Rookie was, I said it was down.
And what were you two talking about, snogging?
Yeah, well, I know, kissing,
but only with certain people.
Wait one second.
What's that, Zaggy Boy?
Wait
One second. That's Zagabo.
I know what character you play, young lady. And by golly, it's not part of the scheme of things or not the same thing.
It's only a character, Zag.
She's a scarlet woman, Christopher.
You're a bit more scarlet than I am at the moment.
Aha! Quite true. Now, listen. Ooh. Zag is now famous for his four-line intros, but there are two of you, and he's got one each. Is that right?
Huh? Oh, yes, indeed. Four-line intro, number one. Katja Pelka is half Irish and half Polish and plays the minx of Brookside.
Scarlet woman.
Who is trying to snare Ted so she can stay in the country. She first appeared in Brookside 1 year ago as a nanny to the Farnhams. Okay.
Is it time for Ted?
Engagement, don't you know, a little bit of a... Do you want to come? Oh,
it's
our
a
party.
Very little ring.
Oh, hey, Ted,
my
bath be there?
What was that?
No. Oh, bath's not going to be there, bath.
Hey,
big bad bath.
He's not going to be there,
No, because big bad bad's going to come along. It's like a spanner in the works again.
Are you?
OK, question time, Brookie style. Right? If you could both play another character in Brookside, who would it be?
That's the worst action in the world.
Okay.
Go on, sorry. Who would?
I'd play Barry actually.
Why? So you can beat Tet up.
Yeah, because I'm hard like that.
Who would you play then, Tet?
He's not there anymore. I'd like to have played Harry Cross.
Yeah, cool. Harry was cool. Hey. God, what a cool character.
Yeah.
Okay then.
Question number two. In your opinion, who is the best neighbour in Brookie? To borrow a cup of sugar from.
Best.
Well, nobody ever spoke to me. That was the problem.
Surprise!
Harris never spoke to me.
I'll tell you. It would have been the Grants when they were there. The Grant family.
They were sound.
Would have been the Grants.
They were.
What about you?
Well, as I say, nobody ever spoke to me.
But
I never get
one.
Invited to parties or
weddings
or anything like that.
You're playing that part!
Because every time you speak to it costs you a few quid, doesn't it?
Okay, question number three. Brookside is a close, confirmed?
Yes.
How close are you two?
I'd say we're inseparable at the moment.
Okay, you're having a few kissing and things in Brookside. Big man!
More money when I want to kiss her.
I've only ever kissed once on Brookside when I tried to kiss Peter, but he wasn't very interested.
Oh, really?
Oh. Okay.
It says here, on the script, Chris points out that every soap guest allowed in our bathroom has to give away a juicy bit of storyline. Can you two reenact a little snippet preview of tomorrow's episode, please?
You're a good reader, aren't you, Chris?
Yeah. Can you do the engagement scene, apparently?
Can we see?
Yes!
Hold your eyes. Got something for you. Right, okay, you can open them now.
Where is it?
Well, you know, the big breakfast.
I'm a serious actress,
I know it's supposed to be a thing, right, but the big breakfast budget doesn't cover it because everyone will be able to work if you went out and bought the $2.99
thing. If the RSC or the National, you'd have a prop.
Yes, there is!
Yes, indeed!
Okay, now we're going to go on to... We're going to go to video games, which has got to be an anticlimax after that, hasn't it, really?
But well, not really, Chris, because it's my part of the show.
This is the first one. Evo, you've got to be quick.
It's called Evo, the search for Eden on Super Nintendo. It's out of US import $49.99. You are one of the first fishing creatures ever to inhabit the Earth. Fight your way through many prehistoric eras. In the search for Eden, not only do you come up against 4.6 billion years worth of scary monsters, but your character evolves according to how well you do. You could get bored with this, but I don't think so. The graphics are spot on. Backdrops are changing constantly.
Okay, good deal.
Game number two. It's called Switch on the Sega Mega CD. The world has gone crazy. Hoovers and lawnmowers are eating everything. Chris, stop it. Magic genies live in hair dryers and dolphins are swimming to your living room. You are this little chap Stop, Chris. Little chap clap, and you and your dog. Your dog stick will sort out the muddle. Japanese import, $49.99.
We were giving you a bit of a jiggle.
Chris, stop it.
Okay.
What?
Right, now, game number three, here it is.
Game number three, the ultimate stuntman on Nintendo. Ooh. Dr. Evil has kidnapped America's top ballistic missile expert and plans to use her knowledge to gain world domination since the FBI failed to topple the dastardly Dr. U. Yes, indeed, the ultimate stuntman are the nation's only hope. This game combines an archive style turbo car chase and platform... Ow!
What?
Out now, cost $29.99. Leave me alone.
Okay, thanks, Zach.
Okay.
Hey, run of applause. Okay, well,
that's been
lovely
done.
Meeting you, bro. And you're welcome back anytime you like.
Yeah.
But not for
Lawrence?
A while. Not for a while, though. In fact.
Oh,
yeah.
It didn't really mean
leave
it.
Leave me a couple of months.
Yeah.
But we'll see the scene that you saw here second on Channel 4 on Brookside.
Just Cliff Richard.
Julie Young from